Erotica in the Face of the Infinite is artwork that's both online as part of an internet work and exists in a physical space as this kind of sculpture that's both a virtual sculpture and then a physical installation. And the website's designed so that you can interact with it and it can also become part of this tower. So in a way, it's your chance to kind of contribute and become part of the artwork itself. So there's an element to the project which involves face detection, and this is something that's built into the browser so that actually when you're observing the work, you can have your face detected and added to the tower as part of an element in it. And once that face is kind of processed for the tower, it's also processed for 3D printing. It becomes a part that you can download and keep and either 3D print or use for other purposes. Tower sort of questions how the internet itself is sort of now evolved from the very early notions of interconnectedness. So this idea that we're all connected via the internet. And now how that has evolved through to like Web 2.0 technologies, social media, infinite scrolling websites that kind of keep growing. There's a kind of a scaling of the internet that is so vast and virtually infinite and so participatory. So in a way, the project is a reflection on all these aspects of what the internet is and has become. The main challenge with creating a work like this is trying to create a system rather than a singular artwork. So instead of thinking about the end result and having ultimate control over that, it's about controlling a system that has a kind of an uncontrolled output. And to do that, the engineering behind that system has to be very robust and has to somehow be successful most of the time, you know, but also allow for serendipity and chances and surprise. And I think finding that balance is the real challenge. So to realize this project, I needed to collaborate with software developers that understood how systems have to be scaled up for potentially hundreds of thousands of internet visitors and operate on servers and be operating at kind of vast, expensive, but fast processing speeds. There's such a complexity to the internet now, and it's also a fragility at the same time. And engineers have to become kind of real experts in kind of working with that challenge. And it's something that's very fruitful about this collaboration, is having someone else understand that fragility and that care that goes into making sure that the internet works and doesn't break. Now that technology or digital technology is so ubiquitous and so part of the fabric of everyday life, digital art almost becomes performative. It becomes like an intervention into everyday life technologies. So I think the challenge is to kind of find the balance between not necessarily trying to innovate, but trying to sort of find the right sensitivity to the subject and still make something poetic as well. I think digital art can do a lot of things for audiences. I mean, some practices are very didactic. They're sort of about making people more aware of the systems that they use or about the infrastructure, the hidden infrastructure. But also, digital art could be used to maybe sort of test boundaries and discuss like social norms, like what sort of etiquette should we have on the internet. I mean, there's always still a research phase to algorithm development, and there's always new papers being published on advances in artificial intelligence. But it's actually the application of those technologies that's interesting. It's when it becomes something that's part of everyday life and they become entangled with very everyday practices, you know, so, you know, shopping or jogging and all these activities that are, yeah, that is actually a very strange thing. It's like this hidden decision-making entity, or this kind of possibly this kind of very reductive understanding of that activity that in a way really shapes how humans operate and how they behave. So in a way there's this kind of nudging or this kind of soft power of automation, which I think is really fascinating.